So the Roman family was based on and very much mimicked the organization of the state. And my favorite term from this, shocker, is an O brother, where art thou reference, the notion of pater familias, the father of the family, right? And basically, the concept is that individual families are like mini states. A father's prerogative is very similar to the state's imperium, the right to command without any type of question. Fathers could do things like sell kids into slavery. Wives had limited rights. And even outside the direct family, there's a system of patronage where people from less important families or people who aren't associated with families at all kind of latch on to those pater familiae and create some type of exchanged relationship wherein they provide services for the family, and in return, the family looks out for them, protects them, provides them with the basic necessities of life. Families themselves are grouped into larger social groups. We might actually consider them tribes, which is a term that's often used to describe them. These are called gentes, one of the terms I have on the opening slide. And within those gentes, you can actually figure out who somebody is, where they are in society by taking a look at their names. And so this is kind of cool. Some more terms that I have on the first slide. Families had, not families, individuals had three separate names. So you can think about this with lots of common Roman names that you've come across before. But the first name is what's called a praenomen. It's like our first name. There's a limited amount. You've got names like Marcus, Gaius, Claudius, Julius, and more often than not, the female equivalents of them, because they aren't all that great at coming up with separate male and female names. So Claudia for Claudius, Julia for Julius, right? Then you get something that's kind of similar to our last name, which is called just simply the nomen, and that's the family or the clan name. And beyond that, you've got what's called a cognomen, and that cognomen is what we might call an extrapersonal name. It's a name that can be identified with different lines of the clan or the family. And so, knowing this, you hear like a mother yelling at her kid. If she were to yell the full name, you'd know what tribe that person belongs in, what sub-cadet branch of that tribe they're part of, and what their name is, and you'd be able to figure out if they're an important tribe, an important family within that tribe, a lesser-known individual. So names are very reflective of social class. They tell you where you sit in society. Within that, I mentioned patronage a little bit. This is where an inferior member of society comes under the protection of somebody more important and more powerful. Normally, they agree to help them in times of need. In some ways, it's kind of like early modern feudalism in terms of the oaths and obligations that pass back and forth. So, patrons provide protection in return. Clients are loyal to the patrons. They do things like run errands, deliver messages, spy. And these relations get passed through generations. So, I like to think about this kind of in terms of Sicilian godfather type relationships there. So, loyalty is to the family and loyalty is to the tribe. And we'll see how, in some ways, this plays out both on that smaller scale, but also in terms of patricians and plebeians, people from kind of the old school, long-term important families struggling with new individuals who come to power.